Welcome to Money Hangout, our weekly interaction to help you learn and understand savings and investment issues. This is brought to you by Birla Sun Life Mutual Fund and Value Research. Today we are going to talk about how does budget affect you? Budget, in fact, the big consolation from this budget is that the widely anticipated capital gains tax did not happen. So it is quite a relief. So the first and foremost thing for investors, and particularly investors in mutual fund, is that your equity funds remain just as attractive as they used to be. You hold it, you invest regularly, invest your long-term money. All the gains that you derive from it will remain tax-free. And that makes it, that is one of the key things which makes equity hold investments very attractive. That apart, two, three small things happened. One is that Rajiv Gandhi equity scheme was quietly buried. It no longer, it was abolished. And so it hadn't gone anywhere. It was not a very popular thing among investors. It was primarily, it was very complex. You must have an investment, income of less than 12 lakh rupees. You should not have a DMAT account. You are investing in, you're making the investment for the first time. You can make that investment only for the first 3 years, and you will get a 50% rebate, 50,000 rupees maximum investment. So that these were actually the problems. So good that it has been quietly buried. I would have welcomed that 50,000 rupees should have been extended to mutual fund exclusively. Nevertheless, I don't think it is a loss for investors at all. That apart, the smallest thing that happened, which affects large number of savers, particularly all taxpayers, is that 12,500 rupee relief in the lowest tax bracket, which affects all other brackets as well. Reduction in the tax rate from 10% to 5% for income below 5 lakh rupees, that I think is going to affect everyone. So effectively, everybody has got little bit of money, little over 1,000 rupee every month to cheer about. Other areas which the budget emphasized, which affects all of us, is that after demonetization, the government is not going to be laid back on black money. It continues its effort to carry on the pressure. Cash payment limit of 3 lakh rupees for businesses, that I think otherwise it will not be an allowed expense. So that is going to really force most businesses to configure the way they conduct business, and it's a good thing. It's important that most businesses legitimize, they account for things, and they conduct their business in a manner which can be transparent. Cash donations to charitable institution trust reduced from 10,000 rupee to 2,000 rupee, including political parties. I think the novelty of that political party, the donation that can be made, that was quite an interesting one. It was very innovative. Now RBI will issue a bond which people can buy, and which companies or individuals can buy, and they can donate it to the political parties. Only political parties can encash that them. So it will maintain anonymity. This was one of the crucial barriers to somebody legitimately making the donation to political parties. Nobody wanted to be seen as making a donation. So this provides a mechanism of legitimately, yet anonymously, make that donation. And this, I think, is after 70 years of debate about political funding, how it should be funded, how to clean up the thing. I think this has come as a big relief. And post demonetization, we expected political parties also to conduct, that is one area which remained largely cash driven. So that is a very welcome thing. Deduction for interest on home loan of a rented property capped at rupees 2 lakh. This is another relief, so to say. The shift to or emphasis of digital payment or digitizing the payment mechanism, digital payment, remained on the forefront of the whole discussion of the whole finance minister's speech. Two, three things. One is the kind of emphasis that had been that was being made about democratizing the usage of Bheem application, the UPI app, that I think will be, and the amount of capital that has been allocated for creating awareness about it, I think it's a very welcome thing. That apart, the two small things, one is the reduction point of sale machine, the manufacture of that, that will become cheaper with you know, substantially reduced or a complete elimination of taxes and duties on them. Of course, IRCTC, the service charge on IRCTC, you know, buying rail tickets has been abolished. This I would have expected, that, you know, government gives little money to all the people who have actually made it one of the largest e-commerce operation in this country over the last 4 or 5 years. We paid for it. While at the same time we were using our bandwidth, we were using our computer, we were not using the railway officials to type our information, and we were paying for it over and above all that. So I would have welcomed some money coming into my account for buying all the rail tickets in the past, but nevertheless, from here on, it becomes a zero cost operation, which is welcome. Saving for your retirement, I don't think we saw any big move here, but small moves definitely came about. Self-employed individuals can now invest up to 20% of their gross total income in NPS to get tax deduction. Of course, this will be in the overall limit of the 1.5 lakh rupee, which is available under ATC. But 20% of your gross income can be made, the contribution can be made in the NPS. So this actually boosts the self-employed. And I would have welcomed, you know, freeing of this retirement thing to be directed to NPS. Investors can, you know, or savers can choose their vehicle of saving for retirement, and they should be at absolute liberty, and all those options should be at par with, you know, NPS. There were quite a few news about your, you know, facilitating making home buying made easier. Affordable housing to be considered as infrastructure. This, I think, is a big boost to affordable housing. And affordable housing, has the definition was liberalized. It was made little, you know, affordable housing was just a room. Maybe now it has become two rooms. So, and the government remains very focused on affordable housing, not the kind of housing that we are referring to. Maybe this is actually meant for the bottom of the pyramid. This is good for the housing finance company. This is good for the large number of consumers there, or people who actually need houses. And quite a few things here. December 31st announcement itself was that interest rate rebate for home loans up to 12 lakh rupees will be available, and that was formalized. Lower long-term capital gains tax. The period for availing long-term capital gains tax was reduced from 3 years to 2 years. That will liquefy, or that will actually incentivize the mobility of houses. A lot of people buy houses and they want to upgrade, they want to change. So this will provide greater mobility. And expanded list of, you know, securities to claim capital gains tax exemption. This was another welcome step. So we had, but the biggest thing that came across from this budget was the government meant business. It was very focused on doing the essentials. There were not too much time spent on making large number of announcements with small allocations. There wasn't much of a populism in this, and it was focused on the essentials. It was fairly elaborate on the detail of many of the things being announced. At the same time, there was not much of things which are considered populist, or small allocation, 5 crore, 10 crore, 50 crore announcements, which take a lot of time. And of course, there were many firsts here. First was that, you know, it was on 1st of February instead of end of February. And the explanation given was that different ministry or different allocation, they will get more time to plan how they plan to spend the money. That part, railway budget was part of it, and the great emphasis on the safety of the railway was the key feature. And it all took less time. So I welcome this budget. Not much great consolation that long-term capital gains did not come through in this budget, and feel relieved with, you know, and everybody got 12,500 rupees, anybody who was paying taxes.